Christians. Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? So say. And do you trust him? Do you intend your son to be his disciple, to obey his word, to show his love? Stephen and Medina, in presenting your son for baptism, you announce your faith in Jesus Christ and show that you want the boy to study him, to know him, to love him, to serve him as his chosen disciple. Will you show your purpose by answering these questions? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? So say, I do. And do you trust him? Your son Roy to be his disciple, to obey his word, and to show his love. Our Lord Jesus Christ has ordered us to pray for and to encourage these children in their walk through life. Do you, who are members of family and friends, promise to do that? By your fellowship to strengthen these children's ties to the household of God. If so, say, we do.
We do.
Let us pray. God our Father, we thank you for your faithfulness that is promised to us in this sacrament. We thank you for the hope that we have in your Son, Jesus. As we now baptize with water, baptize us with your Spirit so that what we say may be your word and what we do may be your work. And by your power, may we be made one with Christ our Lord in common faith and purpose. Amen. St. Louis, Mother, what is your son's food? Now receive into the Holy Catholic Church, which the Father has given to us, and that we should be called children of God. And so we are. Amen. Stephen and now received into the Holy Catholic Church. See what the Father has given us. We should be called children of God. So we in the Scottish Church, there's a great tradition that when the children are brought forth by baptism, parents see that the child is brought forward down the aisle by one of the elders. That's a symbol. The symbol that the child has an autonomy, even beyond the loving parents. The child has a life and a mystery of its own. And we are grateful for the gift of life that is given to us to entrust to us to raise these children as best as God gives us the ability to raise them. It's a joyous occasion, a wonderful time of ingrafting into the wider community of faith. And we are grateful for these families and for their faith. Let us pray. Mighty God, giver of life, you called us by name. You pledged to each of us your faithful love. We pray now for Vincent. Watch over him. Guide him as he grows in life and in faith. Give him understanding and a quick concern for his neighbors. Help him to be a true disciple of Jesus Christ, who was baptized your son, who is our risen Lord. And we pray too for parents, for Nicholas, for Heather. Help them to know you, to love with your love, to teach your truth, to tell the story of Jesus to their son, so that you work and bring about the plans for us that you have promised. for Stephen and for leading me. Help them to know you, to walk with your love, to teach your truth, to tell the story of Jesus to their son, so that your word may be heard and bring about the plans for us that you have promised. Holy God, remind us of the promises given in our own baptisms. Renew our trust in you. Make us strong to obey your will, to serve you with joy, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
It's a rough life.
Yes.
You got some shoes like me.